Relationships these days are very hard, most especially trying to maintain a Christian and godly one. Here on CTN, we are starting a segment called Marriage Talks, where we're going to be able to give advice and guidance on how to maintain a healthy relationship. Today's episode of Marriage Talks, we're discussing emotional love tank. I don't know about you, but in a relationship, if your partner is not in a good emotional love tank, then we need some work to do. Stay tuned and be blessed. Welcome everyone. This is CTN. My name is Chelsea.
My name is Wina.
And today we have a special guest with us, our mommy pastor of our church. And we are going to start a new segment here on CTN called Marriage Talks, where we're going to discuss different topics and questions that you guys might have about relationships and about marriage.
Starting off today, we want to know, what do you think makes a marriage successful?
Thank you. And thank you for having me. It's a great pleasure to be here. There are many components that makes marriage work, not just one. But today, we're only going to focus on one. And that one is to make sure that we keep each other's emotional love time full. What is an emotional love time? Emotional love time is likened to a car, a full tank in the car. When you have a full tank in the car, your car can go a long way. Even you have peace of mind, and you will ride that car with joy and pleasure. So it is in marriage. When your spouse sees the love tank is full, it's with pleasure. Everybody is happy in the house. Everything goes well. But when it's low, now going back to the car, when anyone is driving on a low oil tank or fuel tank, I will say, there's a lot of things that can happen. I will mention three. Over time, the car, the fuel pump, will start getting what we call dirt or sediments or air coming into the fuel tank. And once that happens, and the debris keeps coming into the engine, number one, it slows the performance down. The engine may misfire, and at the same time, it can get stalled. So it is in marriage. When the love tank gets low, we call it emotional love tank, when it's low, what happens is that you see constant bickering in the house. You will see anger festering. You will see lack of cooperation. You will see a lot of conflict. You will see disagreement. You will see that there's no joy in the atmosphere. A lot of criticism, negative talks comes in. And when all that comes into the relationship, you can pretty much know that is either the fuel tank is on low or it's empty. And ways that we actually drain that emotional love tank is through criticism. Sometimes we don't know that we're doing that to our spouse by actually not showing love enough. How do we show love? We want to make sure that we create time for one another. We want to make sure that we speak nice words, good words, positive talk helps to fill those what we call emotional love tanks. So anyone that wants to enjoy marriage, one of the things you want to do is to daily check in with your spouse. What is the gauge? Where am I? Empty, low, middle, half full, or full? And if the answer is low, you now need to check in again and say, what can I do to keep it full? That's where we're going to stop today. So next time we come on, we talk about other ways to keep our emotional love tank full and that of our spouse.
Wow. I don't know about you, but I'm speechless right now. I know we're both looking forward to it. I know you must be looking forward to what we have in tune next. So thank you once again, and we want to see you guys continue on this series with us as we continue Marriage Talks, and we hope to see you again. Thank you.
of my veins.